Consider the following. We cannot do something unless we first thought about doing it. You see, you cannot do anything in life unless first you think about doing the very thing you're about to do. Now this is very interesting and very subtle again. If we really look at our lives, it happens in very mundane things. If you're thirsty, for example, you might notice the thirst in your body. You might be very dehydrated, so you start thinking, I want to drink something. And then if you're in a position to do so, if you're not in some important meeting, unable to get up and get a drink, you get up and you get a drink. When you're hungry, your body tells you that, and you start thinking in your mind, I'm hungry, I need to eat something. And then you walk over to your fridge or wherever else you want to get food, and you get it, and you start eating it. Now this is very basic right there. Now let's consider the following. Can this process work for any other goal that we might set for ourselves in our lives? Well, the beautiful thing is, yes, it actually can work. Now what's the issue here? Well, the issue is our lack of belief in ourselves, that our minds are really that powerful. And another issue is that we usually don't know right away how we can actually achieve certain goals. For example, let's suppose you wanted to create a successful career for yourself, doing something you absolutely love to do in life, whatever your passions are. It could be writing, it could be making music, acting, making films, coaching, I mean, whatever it is that you're passionate about, painting, dancing. There's so many things that people can be passionate about in their own ways. Now let's suppose, if our thoughts are that important, that we cannot do a thing unless we thought about doing it, well then it becomes a matter of us training ourselves to think in terms of success concerning the very thing that we're passionate about. It is a matter of us learning to look at ourselves in a good and better way. It is basically a matter of you taking your very passions in life and daring to think along the lines of, yes, I can be successful with this. Yes, I can make a living with this. Yes, I will dedicate most of my time to executing my passion and purpose in life. Now, once you have that thought going on in your mind, what will happen is a couple of things. First of all, you'll start to notice that perhaps you don't know how to really make a living doing what you love to do. Perhaps you don't exactly know how to go about it, how to turn such a thing into a business or career. Now the beautiful part is that once your career starts to feel like it's a vacation for you, sorta, where it doesn't feel like actual work any longer because you're that passionate, well then you've pretty much reached the pinnacle in life. Because every time we're doing work where we're paying attention to the clock, we can't wait until we finally can go home to relax, to do something else other than the job we're involved in. Well, that's not really passionate work. But once it's passionate work, we all have passions. Well, then life gets very beautiful and interesting. Now, the second thing is, as you start thinking along the lines of, yes, I can, yes, I will, yes, I shall, yes, I have achieved what I already desire to have in life. Once you train your mind to think in that direction, again, you'll be compelled to do the work that needs to be done. This is such a simple concept, but so powerful if you really stop and think about it. We cannot do anything without first thinking about doing the very thing that we want to do. Now, what is it that you want to do with your life? What do you really want to achieve while you're on planet Earth? Because you're not here just by coincidence. Everybody has a unique purpose. They can be similar to other people, but it's still unique to you in a way. You have something special going on about it. When you work on something that you love to do, it sets you on fire. It ignites a fire within your soul. You get excited and passionate. You get motivated. You can actually feel love for the very goal that you're working on. Now, the goal here, the important part to grasp here for yourself and for me, is to always keep an open mind for ourselves and really let the ideas sink into our subconscious minds. Meaning we want to let the ideas start to emotionally drive us. We don't just want to think about what we want in life. We want to feel emotionally in harmony with the very thing we want to do. Now, what do we mean by that? Well, As long as you know that it's something you're passionate about, it's an emotional feeling that you're experiencing as you're working on it. You feel it emotionally. Whatever the words are you give to it, it at least feels positive to you. That's an important signal to grasp. When you're working on something and you know and you can feel that this is important to you, then you're doing something worthwhile with your time. So when you're sitting at home or wherever you are right now, you want to really consider this. If I first have to think something in my mind before I can realize it in my life, what am I thinking about? In what manner am I thinking whenever I even remotely look at my dreams in life? You see, most people, when they think of something they would really want to have in life or how they really want to live, spend more time thinking about reasons why it probably isn't possible. It's again a very subtle difference between people. The person who lives a fulfilled life isn't thinking along those terms. They are simply thinking about what they want, they're emotionally in harmony with what they want, and they get compelled, inspired to execute certain things in life in order to manifest and achieve the very thing that they want. So first, it starts inside the mind. This is another one of those very important parts that you have to clearly burn into your mind, and you have to start working with this concept in your own life, in your own time, in order to see the power that lies hidden within it. So you see, where do you want to go with your life? Just start thinking about it. Just start imagining it. Why are you holding back? You might be holding back because, again, you're not believing in yourself. Perhaps you don't truly believe that you can achieve whatsoever you desire. And that feeling part, that lack of belief that goes on emotionally, is what's causing that blockage in your life. But what if you could get rid of it? What if you would just set those feelings aside? What if you would train yourself on a daily basis to mentally set aside your doubts and simply learn to focus on what you want? Well, I'm going to tell you, you'll be able to manifest it. You'll be able to achieve it. That's the beauty of it all. It's true. I mean, you might still doubt me or others when we say this to you, but it's true. That's the beauty of who you are and the power of your own consciousness. But you have to understand clearly that it's all about how you're using your mind in life that will determine the quality of your individual life. The way you're using your mind determines in which direction you'll grow. We've said this before and we'll say it over and over again from many angles. I'll keep doing this work until the day that I move out of this life. But it's so important for humanity to grasp this, because once they have even the slightest inkling of the power of what's being suggested to them, they will realize what needs to be done, no matter what the goal is that they've set for themselves. The goal is that you want to make sure that your mind is always in harmony with the things you want, and you remove everything that is in contradiction to what you want and that you don't like. So you see, you're learning to process things mentally on a positive note. You learn to look at your life from an optimistic angle so that you don't see the doubts, worries, fears, limitations. I mean, you don't reason along the lines of why something can't be done. You become curious and start reasoning along the lines of how it could be done. Now, even though you might not know the exact way from the moment you start working towards your dream, all these things will be added onto you over time. When you start working towards your dream over a certain period of time, more and more ideas start to add to that purpose, that goal that you've set for yourself, which will help you execute your dream in a bigger and bigger way. This is how it always happens for each and every one of us, so long as we have a normal functioning mind, that is. And I'm assuming you do. So again, as we said at the beginning of the video, you cannot do a thing unless you thought about doing the very thing you want to do. So what do you want to do? Do you want to live a life of success, of happiness, joy, fulfillment? Do you want to live a life where you're executing your passion and even making a living with it? Well, start thinking along those lines. Start building it up inside your mind first and foremost. With this, we mean get a clear idea of what that all is about. What would you be involved in? What would it look like? What would your life look like if it was now your ideal life? And as you start building this up inside your consciousness, and you start removing all the doubts and worries because you're not focusing on them while you're involved in this activity, you're going to find out that your desire to realize that goal is going to increase. It's going to magnify. And as that desire starts burning stronger and stronger inside your very soul, well, that is when you're in the process of receiving the power to make your dream come true, to make it happen. And because most people stop right when they think of what they would want, by thinking in contradictions and limiting ideas and all sorts of reasons why it can't be done, well, they don't ever reach that stage where the desires get magnified enough within their very soul so that they can be compelled to do the work that needs to be done in order to make it happen in their lives. It's something I want you to think about, that you cannot do a thing unless you thought about doing the very thing you want to do. So again, what do you want to do? And once you figure that out, start thinking about it with intent. Start thinking about it with focus. Start thinking about it all day long, every day. You want to start your mind to become dominated by the very things you want and only what you want. Once this sinks in, once you start to grasp the power behind this, then you hold the key to solve any problem you might still have in your physical world. Even though the problem might not vanish instantly, physically speaking, it might be a huge problem. But by directing your mind to a solution instead of focusing on the problem, you'll start to grow towards the solution automatically over a certain period of time. But if we start to focus only on the problem itself, we'll be unable to see the solution because our attention is focused on the wrong thing. Now, with that being said, dear viewer, never forget that we are the dreamers.